And now today is World Environmental Day, aimed at raising global awareness of how we can all save our planet. So we went along to Southseed's community garden on Queen's Drive Lane in the South Side to find out how we in Glasgow can do our bit to make our local communities that little bit greener.
My name is Lisa Peebles and I'm the Administrative Officer for Southseeds, and we are here in the beautiful Queen's Park area of Glasgow working with local people in their community garden at Queen's Drive Lane. The people behind us today are members of the local community. They live in the Queen's Park, Strathbungo, Crosshill and Govan Hill area, and they are here helping to transform an unused, quite industrial space to the rear of some tenements into an amazing community garden. We've been working here for quite a number of months now, and already there's been an incredible transformation. We've gone from a site that was plagued by fly tipping and antisocial behaviour to an amazing community space. We have just recently established our herb swirl, and we've been planting some additional flowers in to encourage some insect life that will help pollinate all the different plants in the area. We've got lots of different foods growing. We have peas, potatoes, kale. Kale is a big favourite amongst local people in this area, so you can never grow too much kale, as we've discovered in our previous gardens. People are just basically maintaining the space that we've established just now. The people who come to Southseeds are not one specific demographic. We're really good at attracting people across what's the age groups, ethnicities, socioeconomic backgrounds. So their reactions and responses are all quite different.
My name's Tim O'Connor, this is my daughter Belle. I've been coming along to the Queen's Drive Lane garden since it started. Just been coming down every week and helping out. I think it's important for kids to learn where their food comes from. If kids grow food, I think they're more likely to eat it as well. It's important that people get more local in where they get their food from. You know, food flies thousands of miles, so if we can grow it, then and we can eat what we grow, then it's really good. And I think people take that away from doing community gardening.
Well, we're joined now by Lisa Peebles of Southseeds, who we saw in the video there. Lisa, could you tell me a wee bit more about community gardens?
Certainly. Southseeds are really lucky. We've got a brilliant area to work in Govan Hill and Strathbungo, Crosshill and Queen's Park. And we've been establishing community gardens and growing spaces for about 3 years there. And we've now, I think, got about 20 spaces all around the area.
Fantastic.
That's brilliant. So what kind of people come along? Who comes along to Southseeds?
Well, our area of operation, as you probably know, is one of the most diverse areas in the whole of Scotland. So we can attract absolutely every kind of person, people across all age groups, ethnicities, and people who, you know, may have quite high pressured jobs, and also people who are just very, very typical. It's a really, really interesting demographic.
Fantastic mix Sounds of people. Mm-hmm. And what do you think they take away from the experience?
Well, apart from the harvest of radishes that they were taking away the other night there.
Tasty growing patch there.
They get a great opportunity to work together collectively with their neighbours, who they probably, you know, haven't met before. And gardening is a brilliant physical exercise. It makes people feel good, and it helps people take control back of their local areas.
Yeah, absolutely.
And the local people taking the responsibility as well, obviously, to improve the local area, that's a big thing.
It certainly is, and it empowers people to face other challenges that they might have in their local area, but it's really, really simple. You know, people don't need to be empowered, they can empower themselves.
Yeah, it's about taking initiative really, isn't it?
Absolutely. If we all were to sit about and think about, you know, someone else coming to solve the problems and the challenges, then nothing might ever happen. Often the best solutions are found at home.
That was quite interesting what you said, Lisa, about people in high-pressure jobs come to let off some steam and relax.
And it's not just high-pressure jobs in the sense that, you know, they're in a big city office. People have complex and quite often difficult lives, and to be able just to come and grow some food and, you know, hang about with people that are in their local area, it's an opportunity just to have a wee bit of space.
Mm. If you were trying to give some tips to somebody who wanted to start their own sort of initiative or go on and do some gardening, what would you give them? What's your top tips?
Well, probably the first thing I would say is don't be fooled or put off by the fact that the environmental issues are huge. You can really take initiative, and all you need is a decent pair of safety gloves and a roll of bin bags, and get out there and clear some space, find some space for yourself. There's always wee pockets of space out there, even if you've not got a garden.
No excuse, got to get out there.
So what did the garden look like before you got your gloves on, the bin bags and Southseeds was born? What did it look like?
Well, that particular space had previously had garages on it, so it had become a bit of a wasteland once the garages had been knocked down. It was quite prone to fly tipping, so it was a bit of a blight on in the local area. As you can see now from the film, it's completely transformed what people are actually looking onto from their homes now.
That's amazing, really cool.
And what do you love the most about being part of Southseeds?
The thing I love about being part of Southseeds is the fact that we have opportunities to make changes in people's lives and to help them make changes. We do lots of energy efficiency work as well, and the combination of that and the community gardening is very, very successful, and people have, you know, comfortable, better lives as a consequence.
Yeah, it's fantastic. Now, it's a World Environment Day. Mm-hmm. Quickly, how would you advise people to help the environment?
I think people just need to identify what the issues are in their local area. Don't take the car, get a bike, you know, have a wee walk. There are very simple things that people can do to make those changes.
Simple changes make a big difference.
Absolutely.
Lisa, thank you so much for joining us. You're hanging about for a wee bit, maybe not on the sofa, but you got your bodyguard entourage with you?
Yes, I have.
Why will you be here?
I'll be here because I think my son and his friends will be on later.
Striking resemblance to a well-known boy band, I believe.
Yes. Much more handsome, of course.
Absolutely. Thanks so much, Lisa. That's
no
fantastic.
Problem.
Now, David, you're over in...